Hey, are you battling with your college debt? Are you struggling to close new patients or just get them in the door?
Our system is designed to create weight loss and nutritional clients into raving chiropractic fans. This program can easily increase or possibly double your income. So get ready and become the chiropractic authority. All right, this is Dr. Tressler.
And this is Dr. Muir. What's going on, everybody?
At the Chiropractic Authority. Here we go, baby. Hey, today's episode, this may be maybe controversy with a lot of people, how I doubled my income, and I'll show you how I did that, under 20 hours a week. And this is a big dilemma in chiropractic where, you know, I still see offices today, they're open at 8 and they close at 6. Or they're open,
Shoot
8 to 5.
Shoot me in the face.
Or they're there till 7, 8, 9 o'clock at night. I've done some of those days where, you're doing reports or workshops till 9. Patients ask you questions. You get home at 10, 10:15. You don't even get to see your family, let alone relax or do anything. You go right to bed. It's just crazy.
And you're killing yourself. And most of the time, as long as it takes to adjust someone, like a minute or not even 2 minutes to adjust someone, unless you're seeing thousands of people a week, you got a lot of free time in between there that you're just wasting time, basically.
Yeah, and you'll hear from docs. I mean, we got up to seeing 800 patients a week under 20 hours. So it was about 17 and a half hours. And we're at right now, we're 17 and a half hours, give or take a little bit here and there. So under 20 hours every week.
Yeah, and the thing with that too is, a lot of you might be listening like, what? Like you spend like 1 minute with a person. Don't you think that the patients, they think you're just rushing them in and out of there? They love it.
Yeah.
You'd be so surprised. They love coming in, getting adjustments, and then going home. Or coming in during their lunch break, getting their adjustment and being able to go back to work. Because one of the most important things, if not the most important thing to people nowadays, is time. Right? Think about like when you go onto the internet. And remember back in the day, like when the internet first started coming out, you're on AOL and it takes 20 minutes to like load up. You have that crazy noise. And then it loads up and then you get on and then you're trying to look something up and it takes 20 seconds for a page to load. Nowadays, if I go on the ESPN or something and it doesn't load in 1 second, I'm pissed. I'm like, what the hell is going on? Like, why am I even paying for this right now? It doesn't come up. People think the same way with their lives. They don't have an extra 20, 30, 40 minutes to come to the chiropractor to get their adjustment and wait in line and, talk to you. They don't care. I can't tell you how many of our patients come and say, Doc, thank you so much. That was an awesome adjustment. Like, I'm so glad that you guys don't spend 30 minutes with me because I just don't have the time. There's no way I'd be able to come here.
Yeah. And I have a lot of patients that have done that over the past. In fact, I think of families right now that have been with me over 10 years. And they've said to me, I had to go to this chiropractor. I would sit in the waiting room. We don't even have a waiting room. Right. I mean, we have a fun house, and sit in a waiting room for 30 minutes to 45 minutes, go back for, quote, treatment. So they would get all kinds of work done on them. And whether you do this or not, right or wrong, then they would finally get an adjustment. And then they would have to go out and wait for their kid to go through the same process.
Oh, God.
And they said, and I have patients said, I did that, and I couldn't stand it. They said, thank you so much. We can come in. Family visit takes 3 minutes. They get their kids adjusted because they're not paying value. They're not paying for your time. They're not paying for your a membership to hang out.
Right.
They're paying for results. If you can't deliver a good principal chiropractic adjustment within a few seconds to a minute, find it, put it in place, adjust, and get the heck out, then you need to train on that. You need to figure it out because I don't do it with my family. My family takes a couple minutes when we adjust each other, 30 seconds. I don't expect 5 minute adjustment. I would at that point, I would be like, he doesn't want that. He's doing, man.
You know what you're doing, bro. Yes.
Like, get me out of here. I'm getting someone else.
I mean, that's like the number one complaint most people have with medical doctors is what do they have to do? You go to the office, then you sit there in their stupid waiting room and watch their fish swim around in their fish tank. And then after that, man, I just spit all over you, my bad.
Boom.
And then after that, if you sit in there looking at their fish tank, then they bring you back. And then after they bring you back, the nurse comes in. And then the nurse is there for 10 minutes with you.
Who
and
wants
then
to go
that,
back?
Then the doctor finally comes in. You're there for over an hour. And you're like, man, what
Slice
the hell?
My wrist and let me bleed.
Yeah.
You can't. Nobody wants that. And if they want that, let them go to a different office. You know, you create your environment that you want, and they'll love you for it. So let's get into this. How in the heck did I double my income under 20 hours? So, you know, I was working 20 hours, and I implemented a new system, and I didn't work more, yet I doubled my income. So one of those things, you know, so years ago, and this is how this all started, the innate life system, or how we created this, the chiropractic authority, why I even got to this point. I was training for my marathons, my ultra marathons, and because of that, I eat, you know, healthy, I exercise, I work out, I was running, you know, 40, 50 miles a week, and these were trail marathons, so they were a little tougher than, you know, road marathons. And what happened one day, and this sucks, is I didn't know I was gaining any weight, and I didn't know I was under stress, sympathetic stress. I didn't even know what all that stuff meant at the time. But I went to put on my dress pants, and the damn things were too tight.
How was that possible? You're running so much, you eat healthy, you know, what the heck?
That's what I said. And I'm like, that damn dryer, man, it must have turned off the heat. Yeah, what are they doing?
Your pants.
Shrunk my pants. And I tried on another pair. I'm like, dang on it, man. Some of these dress pants are too tight. So I had a couple pairs. So I went out, and I'm like, I can't. I mean, my stomach was hurting. They were tight all day.
Cutting off circulation to your legs.
My organs. I'm like, what the heck? So I ended up buying some size 33 pants. I'm like, okay, this will fit. And then I went home, and I'm like, this is bull crap, man. I am not keeping 2 inches on my waist. I've never had this in my life. And if you're overweight, or if you have some belly fat, or maybe you can relate, maybe you can't. You may at one point in your life. I was about 42 years old, so I thought maybe hormones were changing. And I said, this can't change. You know, I got to change this. So I started looking into systems. You know, how do I lose weight really quick? And for all the years, I've been in practice 21 years. All those years, I would just tell patients, hey, eat right and exercise. Just do it. What was interesting is, and I started to correlate this at the time, was every time I would go out and run, my legs would feel heavy. I would feel tired, but I would run anyhow, and I would clock myself. You know, I had to keep my time at a certain, you know, time per mile. I would train sometimes at 6.5, you know, minute pace, 7 minute long distance. You know, I was really pushing myself. My legs were feeling like they were cement. It was really weird. And I'm like, son of a gun, maybe I need to stretch more. Maybe I need to take more protein shakes. Maybe I'm dehydrated. And I tried all these different things. Nothing worked. And I didn't realize at the time, but it was stress. It was a stress response happening internal. So anyway, going back, I started looking at all these weight loss programs, and I tried some things. I remember Tim Ferriss's program. He talks about the four-hour body. I looked at that. And I'm like, yeah, this makes sense. I'm going to implement some of these things. And here's my personality. I'm not big on going to a completely 100% diet program, saying, right, okay, I have to diet. I'm never going to eat sugar again. I'll never eat bread. You know, I do it probably 90, 10, 85, 15, something like that. And I figure we should be able to lose 10 pounds, and you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to trap yourself in a box where all you're doing is eating raw or vegan, and you can never eat anything bad again. I'm thinking this is just, that's not normal.
That's unsustainable too.
Unsustainable. And the stress there. And I see people that do it, and they're not healthy.
Right.
And it may be emotional. You know, they're so emotionally trapped. So I remember doing Tim Ferriss's thing, and I lost about 4 or 5 pounds, and one of the components was, and maybe this was an option, was sit in an ice bath for about 15 to 20 minutes.
Just freeze your ass off.
And I did that for my running, my legs. I did an ice bath for my legs. It was great, take inflammation out, but submerge yourself in an ice bath because you would shiver and you would burn off about 100 calories, if I remember right. That's what I said. And then I dawned on me, who the heck is going to do what patients? Well, they're not even cutting out bread.
Yeah.
They're going to do an ice bath? Oh. This is, again, unsustainable. So, but anyhow, I lost about 4 or 5 pounds. And then I took the weekend and I said, you know what? I'm going to ease up a little bit. Eased up, and son of a gun, I gained it all back. And I thought, this is what our patients are dealing with.
Right.
They're trying to implement a program that is very hard to sustain, very hard to continue, and they know they can't do it for life. Mm-hmm. So where are they going to go after they're done with the program? And they'll lose some weight, and they go to a picnic, and they gain it all back. And they're so frustrated. So they're trying all these different avenues. So I looked into a program that was being taught by a bunch of chiropractors, a system that yield, you know, said that it could yield fast results, you know, lose 10, 20 pounds really quick. But you know what? That's what I want. I want something quick and easy. It made sense. I didn't agree with every component, but it made sense. So I did it, and I did. I lost 10 pounds in 10 days. And in about 14 days, my 2 inches were gone.
Sweet.
And I thought, there's something to this. Although I didn't like all the components, there was something to it. And I thought, wow, maybe I could do this with my patients.
Right.
They could do this. You know, to anyone loses 10 pounds in 10 days, they get excited. So we started implementing it, and immediately people were buying these programs. And programs run anywhere from like $1,200 to $2,200. We sold ours for $1,500. And people were handing money over, leftover.
Like, you know, it was nothing.
Like it was nothing. You know, when you say chiropractic, $1,500,
crap. They're stunned. Should my insurance cover that?
Insurance. What about my insurance? And the other thing, what about my insurance? What about the last chiropractor that gave me all my services and I never had to pay anything?
Right, for free.
We're up against that, too. And they were handing this over. And I'm like, holy cow, my income's going up quick. Yeah. Like, son of a gun, as long as I attract weight loss clients in, they'll buy these programs. Yeah. I mean, it was working phenomenal. So we were growing in practice. So what was interesting, and I didn't double my income just yet, but I increased it sometimes as much as 10 to 20,000 by just doing weight loss. It wasn't hard. So then I said, you know, what if we can get them under chiropractic care? I could double, you know, triple my income, really. Maybe even quadruple with long-term care. And I said, so the chiropractors that were teaching this program, I'm not going to mention names, but they said, once you get the client in, you sell them a weight loss program, tell them they get a complimentary chiropractic exam. Sounds good to me.
Sounds all right.
Wouldn't anyone want that?
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, sure.
So about maybe 30% would take me up on it. Only 30.
Okay.
So 3 out of 10, all right, that's better than zero.
Right.
But what happened was they wouldn't schedule for maybe a week out and maybe 10 days out when they would do their weight loss consult. And by the time I did their exam, took x-rays, and they're wondering, why do I need my spine adjusted or cracked when I'm trying to lose weight?
Right.
We didn't have an answer.
I mean, that's a legitimate question.
It's very.
It's like, why the? I wouldn't know. You know? I'd be like, what the hell?
It
like,
sounds foolish.
What does it have to do? I don't have neck pain or back pain, bro. Like, why do
and
I
And even
to
if
do-
you did...
It's What's probably that have from to the do weight.
Weight, right?
Yeah. They would say, "Well, my low back probably hurts because I have all this extra weight."
What about your headaches? Well, if I can get rid of my weight, I bet my headaches will go away. What about your neck pain? If I can get rid of my weight, I think my neck pain will go away. I don't sleep well. If I get rid of my, you know, weight, everything was related back to weight. So what happened was, and this was a knife in my back, a dagger. They would come back after their, you know, first consult in 10 days, 14 days, and I'd say, "Hey, we're going to review your X-rays and stuff," and I'd show them, and they're like, "You know what, Doc? That's nice, but I'm okay. My headaches are gone. Yeah. I've lost 10, 15 pounds. I feel great. I've never felt this good in all my life. Thank you so much. You're the greatest weight loss guy I've been around."
Oh, how'd that make you feel?
I sucked. I wanted to like hang myself. I'm like, son of a gun. I was so pissed that I would leave and I would say, these people are being lied to. I am not telling them the truth. I'm not giving them the whole picture here, because if they lose their weight but their nerve system's under stress, are they going to be healthy?
Nope.
Never.
No chance.
They'll be better, but they're not going to be
and
healthy.
I think that's why a lot of docs who are doing various weight loss programs, they're just doing it like what you started off was doing, is like they don't know how to merge the two, or they don't want to merge the two.
It's too
easy.
Just
want to be like, here, I'll just take my $1,600 per weight loss and boom, we'll go from
and
there.
And you never have to see them.
Yeah.
Two or three times, that's it.
Right.
And they'll be back because they'll regain it.
Yep, exactly.
And we've had patients say they were at their chiropractor 2-3 times. It worked every time.
Yeah.
We're like, well, there's a new sheriff in town.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, do you want to do this once and keep the weight off, or do you want to just keep spending your money over and over again?
So I got frustrated, and I said to my staff, I am going to find a way to include chiropractic with this program. And they're like, oh, that'd be great, but how are you going to do it? I kept trying all these different angles. Nothing was working. And then I started reading a lot of Chestnut stuff, James Chestnut, sympathetic stress response, the hormone response. The sympathetic system, when it's under stress, it can trigger things like cortisol goes up, belly fat goes up.
People know about cortisol.
Leptin shuts down, hormones shut down, the hypothalamus doesn't work properly, your thyroid doesn't work properly, metabolism, your blood pressure may go up, your cholesterol may go up, you're fatigued, your adrenals shut down, low energy, and you don't sleep. What are all the side effects of being overweight?
Same exact thing.
And if your lifestyle sucks, that's going to create that in a mm-hmm. sense. But if your nerve system's under stress, it's going to create the very same thing. They had the same response.
Exactly.
And what I realized is I started reading and researching. I went to his seminars, incredible stuff. I realized that's what I was suffering with. Sympathetic stress. I was driving myself with exercise, thinking if I just exercise more, I'll burn this stuff off no matter how I eat. And I was eating well. It yeah. wasn't happening because my sympathetic nerve system was under stress. It wasn't calm and relaxed, and I couldn't heal. Until I relaxed, I actually stopped exercising for a while, and my body started to heal.
Wow.
And then what happened was, is after I, you know, I kept getting adjusted, but I learned how to keep my sympathetic system calm, my parasympathetic activated, and I actually put on about 13 pounds since I lost it, but my waist is still the same. My body fat's still the same.
Right, so you just added more muscle.
Yeah, I'm stacked, man.
Yeah. Well, I don't want to go that far, but you're in good shape.
Like,
I'll say
when
that
you look
sure.
at Zeno,
oh, yeah.
Zeno's arms, you look at my arms.
He's humongous.
No resemblance.
Oh, my gosh.
But I realized that's what was happening. So I thought, can I introduce the sympathetic system into the workshops that we were doing? We were killing them in the workshops.
Right.
And everyone was signing up. So I said, you know what? I'm going to include it. But here's a great takeaway, docs. You, and this may sting your ego, but let it sting and let it settle, is when I did this in the workshop, I talked physiology, sympathetic stress response, healing, but I didn't talk subluxation and chiropractic.
Huh.
At all.
Why?
Because when you say chiropractic, what do they think?
Oh, yeah, they get scared. They're like, oh, I don't want to get my neck. I could see Chuck Norris rip people's heads off, Steven Seagal. That's what they think you do.
And when they would come to the workshop in the beginning, when they knew that I was a chiropractor, they would all, oh, God,
oh,
this
crap.
Is a trick. Mm-hmm. He's setting me up. Now they would come in and I never say I'm a chiropractor. I'm a doctor. Yeah. I've been a doctor for 21 years in health. I'm going to show you what I do. And then they find out in a minute, but I explain the physiology. And then they say, well, this makes sense.
Right.
And what's the second question or response they always say is, why didn't anyone tell me this? I've been regaining my weight year after year. I can never keep it off. Mm-hmm. Maybe this is why. 90 to 95% regain their weight in 1 to 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
Is this part of it? If you don't address this, and that is chiropractic, they're never going to heal. So once I introduced that night, I'll never forget it. It was a groundbreaking night. I introduced the sympathetic stress response, the hormones, the chiropractic principles, and I said, this is why we look at both systems and make it into one complete game plan.
Yeah.
Sign up in the back. They all ran and they signed
That's
up.
That's awesome.
You've done them all.
That's awesome.
And then what was interesting, when they come in for a day one, remember those days, they would come in expecting us to look at their nerve system.
I want the chiropractic exam. When are you going to do the chiropractic part? That's what I would get in a day one. I'm like,
When they only came in with a weight loss ad.
Yes.
The attraction's there.
Because the thing is, you know, it's not that you're hiding that you're a chiropractor, or it's not that you're hiding subluxation or any of these things. It's just when you get the person in, you have to draw them in for a certain thing, like weight loss, or if you draw them in with headaches or neck pain or whatever. Yes. It's the same thing. They're all symptoms. They're all side effects of a body that's dysfunctioning. So when you bring them in, you know, what you don't want to do right away is, you know, I'm from Ohio, so I'm a huge Ohio State fan. Okay, so if anyone knows anything about Ohio State, we hate that team up north, Michigan. It makes me sick to even say Michigan. So if I met someone and they told me something, it's funny because my best friend's a Michigan fan, but before we were best friends, I didn't know that. Otherwise, who knows what would happen. But if someone was like, dude, I love Michigan. Immediately, without me, if I didn't know you, I'd be like, I don't know if I want to talk to this dude right now.
Jerk.
You know, or like Pittsburgh, if you're a Philadelphia fan.
Or Cleveland Browns. I'm busting your head.
You're out. You're like, dude, I don't want to talk to you at all. So that's the thing. Like, you don't want to stop them from being able to come in and hear what you have to say right away.
Yeah.
Once they get there, then you explain physiology, you explain how the body works, how, you know, the sympathetic stress hormone response works, and then you go into, and that's what chiropractors do, that's what we help you with. And then they're
like, this is great. This makes sense.
This is awesome.
You know, here's the thing, we'll kind of wrap up with this I really want you to get a hold of this, docs, and if you can start implementing this in your practice, it will be a game changer. And this is how we doubled our practices. They signed up for weight loss and chiropractic, mm-hmm. so it was double the money, sometimes triple, quadruple the money, paying us for one system. Yeah. It wasn't separated. What intrigued me to start this whole innate life system and why we created, Dr. Muir and I created the Chiropractic Authority to teach this and show you how this is done, is one main thing, is I saw doctors, chiropractic doctors, principal subluxation, life graduates, talking yeah. subluxation, stop chiropractic care in their office to just do weight loss. I said, this is not a good future for us. Nope. Not for chiropractic, not for my family, my kids, and my surrounding. Bullshit. We're changing this thing. We're creating it. We're going to show people how to do it. And it can be done. Here's the takeaway. Listen to this. If somebody came in, if you ever advertised a carpal tunnel ad or a TMJ ad or a low back or a headache, you wouldn't have in one part of your clinic low back treatment, trigger point, massage, stem. I do CBP, you know, we do CBP and Pettibon stuff here, correction care, wobble chair, those kind of things. But even if you do traction and physical therapy type care, you wouldn't put that in one part of your clinic and just do an exam for that and say, hey, by the way, we're going to check your spine out too. That's completely different. It's one system. You're examining what's causing their problem. If their weight loss, weight gain is a symptom, that's it. It's a problem they have. Their body is not functioning. They're gaining weight due to lifestyle and subluxation or nerve system stress, sympathetic stress. But isn't that with a low back?
Yeah.
If they sit around the couch all day, their lifestyle. They don't exercise, their lifestyle. They eat a lot of sugar and processed food, their lifestyle. Couldn't that cause an inflammatory response, weak muscles, weak spine, degenerative disc, and cause pain? Nothing to do with adjustments.
I'd have to say so, yeah.
So then we say, well, all we're going to do is adjust you. You can go home, sit on your couch, eat inflammatory foods all day, eat sugar, smoke cigarettes, and have poor posture and never exercise, and the adjustments are going to take care of it. Bullshit.
Yeah, no chance. What happened to the three T's? You know, the most principled docs who might have issues.
TV started with
who
it.
Who might have issues with weight loss or these other programs addressing symptoms and those sort of things. You know, we're principled, but if you're like stuck on that boat, it's like, so we talk about the three T's that could cause subluxation. So if they do have those toxins, the poor food choices, the smoking, the alcohol, the medications, if they're on those, you know, docs, you know you don't want your patients to necessarily be on medications. So what's the difference between you telling them, hey, listen, there's some other healthy alternatives instead of these medications that you might be taking, or, hey, man, we should get you to lose some weight because that excess 50 pounds around your belly is crushing your discs.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's all a symptom. And here's the bottom line is you want to attract more and you want to sign people up for lifetime wellness care. You're not going to do it selling just a weight loss plan. Our system will show you exactly how to combine this into one. If you want to have lifetime family care, you don't just talk about the headache and the chemicals causing the headache. You talk about the three T's, get their family under care so their kids don't have to eat the toxins, get adjusted to be subluxation free for their entire life, avoid vaccines, all that stuff. You have to take them, you have to meet them where they are and start pulling them up this ladder. Where they're at is not, hey, I'm looking for a subluxation-based chiropractor. Right. We had one lady last week come in and say, I want to be adjusted and have my spine optimized correction because I know this takes care of my life. And I said, you've been to a good chiropractor. She said she was a CBP chiropractor.
Yeah, she was at a CBP doc in Seattle.
And
so it's like,
then
you
she
know,
ended up
like,
working
she's
there.
The one freaking person in the last 21 years who asked for subluxation. She's been getting adjusted.
No, I think there were like three.
My gosh. So three in 21 years. It's ridiculous.
Yeah,
that's the first one that I've had.
So they're not going to come in. How are they ever going to hear your voice, your message, if all you're doing is shouting pain or subluxation or chiropractic? Meet them where they are. Love them. Bring them in. Talk about, hey, I know you're here to lose weight. I want to tell you two different things. Lifestyle can cause you to gain weight. And they'll say, I know. I love sugar and I love fat. But you know what else? If you have a stress or a sympathetic stress on your spine due to posture and immobility, motion not moving properly in your spine, aka subluxation. I don't even talk that way in the beginning. I just tell motion and structure and posture, like, I have poor posture, doc. This can cause a sympathetic response that will drive your sympathetic system through the roof, fight or flight, they all shake their head, and cause more weight gain, more cortisol, more belly fat, and more health problems. We're going to check this out. And they look at me and go, my God, why hasn't somebody told me this?
Let's do this.
Thank you. Let's do it. And they whip out their wallet.
Yep.
So, you know, if you're wherever you are in practice, you know, one, I would say head on over. Check us out. Listen to the stuff. Our program is amazing. If you're interested, sign up for a free phone consult to see, you know, if this is the right program for you. We don't accept everyone into our program. We want this to be right for you so you don't spend another dime on a silly program, waste your time money.
Waste your money and your time on some dumbass freaking weight loss program where you don't get to be a chiropractor.
Right. Or you buy a kit. And a month later, you do nothing with it.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you know, we'll talk to you personally, see how, and we'll show you how this works. It is an amazing program. There's not a coaching program or system out there like ours. And you not only can double, maybe triple your practice, but you're going to be a chiropractor the whole way through. But it just opens the floodgates to attract new people. So I hope that as you leave here today, start implementing that talk into your practice. Don't talk weight problems as a different entity, part of a system, a symptom, just like back pain or headaches, and you have an answer for them. Just say that. And if they say, well, what's your answer? Say, well, I'll have that shortly for you. And then join our program.
Yeah, exactly.
In 4 weeks, you could sell these programs. I'm telling you, it's amazing.
Oh, yeah, we already have docs doing it. Within the first month, they're already selling programs. Yeah. They're buying more programs.
So, and they're saying it's crazy. Easy.
Yeah, so what you guys need to do is, if you're interested in any of that information, run on over to thechiropracticauthority.com or check us out on Facebook at The Chiropractic Authority, where you'll see Dr. Tressler and my handsome face.
That's K-Dog, the handsome man.
That's it. This K-Dog signing off.
And T-Bone.
All right, we are The Chiropractic Authority.
For more information about The Chiropractic Authority, run on over to thechiropracticauthority.com,
where you can start training today on our free videos, free training material, webinars, PowerPoints, our innate life systems, coaching, and much, much more. This information will blow you away.
So thanks for listening, and until next time, this is Aaron.
And this is Kyle.
We are the Chiropractic Authority.